Hello, thank you for joining today's briefing. I'm Agent 78 and today I will briefing you about the newest development in USR technology. If you have missed the last briefing about the TDS Vanguard, I highly recommend that you keep yourself up to date in case it goes into production. I also want to remind you that these ships are only prototypes and may never see combat. My sources have informed me that the United Space Research Trickster prototype is in testing. A fast and agile support ship that is made to disrupt the enemy team while making sure that its allies can get in and out of engagement safely. This ship specializes in hit and run combat while supported by a heavy or attack craft, and will surely meet its early demise if caught alone by even the weakest of ships. Its primary weapon is a low rate of fire flak cannon. This weapon, though similar to the Colossus flak cannon, is far fewer in number, resulting in a lower rate of fire. It is primarily installed to take out missiles and small craft defense. It is also proficient at keeping ships with visual concealment abilities out of stealth because of its area of effect damage. With a range modifier installed, it can support its allied ships up to 17 kilometers with constant harassment. On the secondary fire button is a blink installed, a modified blink drive that instead of just teleporting the trickster to a location, its main focus lies in making sure that the team is in position to engage or to get friendly ships out of combat before they take critical damage. It can also be utilized for transporting heavier ships on the way to the enemy FOB. This ability is best used when communications officers in the team are all sharing positions and status with each other over voice comms, to avoid blinking when it's not wanted. The maximum range of this blink is 15 kilometers and comes in 3 variations. Take note, the ship will not be able to engage the blink when the jump drive is spooling up. The standard variation is a quick blink. This switches a targeted friendly ship with the position of its own. Because the blink drive does not augment the ship, it will be off cooldown and ready to use the fastest out of the 3 variation. This makes it the perfect pick for transporting heavies into the front lines where they shine. Second on the list is a shield blink. This will give the trickster a shield similar to the Watchman's for a short duration of time, to ensure its own survival when taking the inevitable damage that it would surely have taken, making it a perfect tanking ship for high burst damage, like a Leviathan Beam or a Salvo of a Lurking Ghost. The drawback is that the recharge time is higher as the standard switch blink and takes precise timing if one to be used to maximal potential. The final version is a heal blink. Upon a successful jump, the targeted ship will restore a portion of its hit points. This small boost is perfect to ensure that the allied ship will be able to get back to its FOB. It can also be an effective way for getting a heavy topped off before you send it into the enemy ranks to wreak havoc. Like the shield blink, it takes longer to recharge but doesn't require the timing. Instead, a crew with high situational awareness is advised to be recruited for missions with this blink system installed. The first ability installed on the trickster is a thrust pulse. When activated, it will send out an unguided pulse of energy. When applied to an enemy ship, it will overload the main engines, sending it forward at max speed for the duration of the pulse, forcing it out of cover and into an unfavorable position. It is a good way to make sure that the enemy misses its mark when applied at the right time. The other variations of the pulse will force the enemy ship to bank in a left or right curve, and it is developed to make it harder for ships with forward-facing weaponry to acquire a target. In the drone base, it had a squadron of trick drones. The drones are made for single target disruptions and making it harder to fight for the affected ship. The trickster comes stock with anti-HUD drones. When a drone starts affecting the hostile ship, it will cast information about the status of the weapons and utility system to be false, giving random information that keeps changing the entire time while applied. These drones take a few seconds to start working, while reading the target ship's current status, giving the enemy time to prepare and try to memorize the cooldowns on the ship. The second batch of drones that are available to the trickster are alarm drones. These drones will trick the alarm into thinking that certain events are happening in the vicinity. To give a few examples, they may cause the missile alarm to go off, or to say that an enemy ship has decloaked or started jumping, making the enemy flutter while they're trying to get a grip on its surroundings. The third option is a drone type that will target the ship's identification systems. When these systems are impaired, all ships will show up as friendly, and it is up to the captain himself to determine if a ship is friendly or hostile. This can be done by the ship type, the camouflage, or the name of the captain. It will cause some relief when the enemy captain is focus firing one ship, because he surely doesn't want to go through the trouble of identifying all ships around him, or otherwise it will delay him when he does so. the trickster is also fitted with a detection method. Again, there are three different variations that you will need to look out for and understand while facing the ship in combat. The first is the detect probe. This is a medium speed projectile with a 5 km detect range. The probe will keep traveling until destroyed by a hostile ship or colliding with a solid object. This option is great for a targeted scan of an area or an overall scan of the sector. It can also be equipped with a detect rocket. Although it only has a detect radius of 3 km, because of its increased speed, it is perfectly suited if you want to scan a part of space quickly, when you know where the enemy is hiding. When the captain isn't sure if there are any cloaked ships around in the sector, it would be advised to install the detect torpedoes on the the trickster. Although much slower, its 7 km detect range is sure to make up for that. This with time will map out a large area of the sector, but be advised. The slow speed will give any cloakers ample of time to fly over or under the detect torpedo if it is launched far enough away from them. So in short, the Trickster is a ship that specializes in disrupting the enemy team and ensuring good positioning of its own team. From this information I deduce that it's meant to fly forward to scout out the sector and cap mines in the progress, because of its high speed in comparison with most other ships in current use. When coming against opposition, it can switch out with a heavy trailing behind it and supporting it from afar. When any ship is under heavy fire and about to take critical damage, it is the Trickster's job to make sure that the ship gets out of the combat zone and fly back for repairs. That is all the information currently available to me about the USR Trickster. Thank you for attending this briefing. I have some solid information that Zerg Industrials is retrofitting a ship into codename Extractor. I will have more intel on that next time. May you fly in safe sectors, and remember, information is the key to success.